blood pressure?
I am good. I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great. I'm in an AKA meeting and end this at the same time.
Awesome. Well, thank you for joining us.
Oh, no problem. I'm glad to be here. I really love Dr. Wood, and I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Yes, ma'am. Likewise.
So I'm just going to go back on silent.
Okay. Thank you for joining. Thank you.
Hello there. How y'all doing?
We are good.
Hey. We're doing
Ramsey.
Good. How are you?
Thank you. We are just loving. Oh, it's just wonderful.
Excellent.
Finishing up now.
Excellent.
Hey, Joe. How are you, Brother Tasby? How are you? Okay. Can y'all hear me?
Yes, ma'am. We can hear you.
And hello there, Sister Shante. Thank you. Hello there. Hey, brother.
Hi. Hello, how are you?
Oh, wonderful. Listen, thank you to you and brother. Thank you so much. You know you're part of our family, right? Y'all are my brother and sister from another mother.
Yes.
My brother and I have adopted you. How you doing, Brother Joe? Good to see you, brother. Hello there. How are you, Brother Taylor? I'm Sister Deborah. I'm a Zeta too, so I don't know how we refer to each other, but hello there, friend. Oh, is that Megan? Oh, my God. Daddy, you better get over here, Daddy. Yo, hello there, girl. Your show is about to start. Let me turn this thing up here.
It's in a purple and black thing.
Oh, wonderful.
The burger's already made.
Hello there, all these friends. Hello, sir. I'm sorry. I
don't think it's that low down in there either, Zach.
I'm not familiar. Daddy, your show is about to start.
Freaking A.
Where's the man of the hour?
And Brother Carl, you know you're special. You're the extra brother. Now we got a big family. Because my brother and I was just the two of us for years, you know?
Yes, ma'am.
So now we got more brothers. Birthday, man.
Oh, my Lord.
Hello.
Happy birthday.
Oh,
man.
My Lord.
Oh, happy birthday.
Miss Megan.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Wow. This is too much. This is too much. I should have had a shot of bourbon before y'all showed up. This is wonderful. Brother Carl.
Somebody should bring you some.
Yes, this is just great. Brother Taylor, who instigated all of this? This is a good instigation.
Yes, it is.
Oh,
this is on behalf of your chapter, Eta Rho Sigma.
Thank you. Thank you so much,
that
brothers.
Came together to do this.
Oh, my Lord. That's so wonderful. So wonderful. And y'all knew who to get on here, too, didn't you?
We have more. We have more coming.
Hello, Sister Shante. You and
how are you?
I am just listen. I'm beside
Happy
myself.
Happy birthday!
Thank you so much. This is awesome. Oh my Lord! Look at that! Look at that! Look at that, Brother Carl. Y'all got Carl on there. Hey, Brother Carl. Brother Hunt.
Is that Carl with a K or Carl with a C? I I don't know which call you're referring to.
But I was talking with the C call at the time.
Well, then I am glad to be here and happy birthday.
Well, thank you so much. And Brother Hearn, this is just great indeed. Hey, Megan, I ain't seen you in a long time. It's been about 1 year, right?
I think it's been about two years,
isn't it? Yeah.
We missed you Thanksgiving before last because you guys went to California. And then COVID after that.
So, that's right, exactly. Oh, my Lord. Right. Did I see Justin?
Yes, you do.
Hey, Brother Justin. How you doing, baby? Oh, my Lord. This is so wonderful. Oh, y'all got Brother David. Hey, Dave. Oh, my goodness. That, don't y'all give me a heart attack up here in a minute. This is so wonderful. This is like going to heaven without dying. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my Lord.
Yeah, Megan told me I was on mute.
Oh, my Lord. This is so wonderful. I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful.
Somebody. Happy birthday, Pastor.
Well, thank you so much. It's just wonderful to be. I figured when I got to be 90, I'd dance on the moon with Michael Jackson. I think it's like that, you know. This is so wonderful. Thank you. Brother Joe, we've come a long way.
Yes, sir, Doc, we sure have. God bless you, man. I just love you so much. You know,
thank you.
You're totally respected, man. We just appreciate you for the legend and wonderful person you are.
Thank you so much, Brother
Joe. Yes,
sir.
It's a pleasure. We've
come a long way together.
Amen.
Yes, yes. Brother Cheatham, Brother James Cheatham. Is that a Aderon brother?
That's right.
Yes, it is.
Hey, Brother Cheatham, we'll meet one of these days beyond. This is great.
That's the General Cheatham.
And how are you?
I'm fine, sir. And I'm just beside myself with delight. You all have just blessed me. So, as I say, it's like going to heaven without dying.
Yeah, but you paved the way for us.
Well, you know what?
You laid the foundation and helped lay it and whatever and, you know, gave us the path.
Well, thank you. I did my little part here and there, you know.
Oh, sure. You did a lot.
And, you know, as I look around, those of us who came through then, our numbers are dwindling, so.
True.
You know, that I'm just delighted when we can get together and share. So, Shardy, how are things going up in your country? Is it San Antonio?
Oh, yes, sir. That's where I am right now. I just got off work.
So oh, my goodness.
Sorry about that, but I didn't miss your birthday for the world.
Thank you. This is so good of you all. Oh, yeah. That's right. And,
okay. But Doc, we should have a few more joining here. We got it reserved until I believe 8:30, and people may come and go.
Yes.
Now we have a special video presentation that will run. I believe we're going to try to start that at 7:30.
Okay.
So I think you will enjoy that.
Yes. And I just had a sumptuous dinner. Thanks to you know who. Both of y'all know who you are, and I'm going to be eating all the week on that. It's first class stuff.
Hey, there's Ryan. You see Ryan?
Hey, Brother Ryan. Oh, my Lord. This is wonderful.
Happy birthday, Brother Virgil.
Yes.
Got Johnny Sandals.
Brother hey, Sandals. Johnny, I see you.
Where's Johnny?
Johnny's right there. You don't need it, Johnny.
How you doing, Dr. Wood?
Hey, Jack. How you doing, brother?
Happy birthday to you, sir.
Well, thank you. It's a delight to be here with y'all.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
If I knew, if I'd known this could be so great, I'd have done this a long time ago.
Hey, happy birthday, Pastor Wood.
Oh, Kara, thank you. Kara. Hey there, girl.
Hey.
Yes, oh, we got the whole Monroe crew. Yeah. Oh, my Lord.
Yeah.
I think I baptized all three of y'all, didn't I?
You did.
And I didn't drop you in the water.
You did. Hey, that was when, yeah, that was all the way in the water. When
got all the way. That is great.
Hi, Miss Lillian.
Hey, Miss Lillian.
Come closer, honey.
You can. How are you doing?
We'll chat and share.
Let me get
Come on. Yeah, here we are. Here we are. Okay,
y'all. Yeah.
Oh,
yes,
yeah.
Here we are.
Yeah, yeah. You know, this lady and I met 70 years ago.
Wow.
Seminole.
Yeah, that's right.
Smiling.
Still high and full
thinking. It's a good thing and a good thing.
Yeah, she.
That
can't
be
great.
Got an Owen join.
Yeah, looking Cardwell. Good there, Doc.
Hey, hey, Brother Owen Cardwell.
Yeah.
How you doing, buddy?
How you doing?
I'm doing great, man. I feel like I had a shot of something. I've been smoking something. I'm feeling so good.
I know.
I ain't been smoking a thing. I ain't been chewing nothing. Yeah, Sharon. Hey, Sharon. Oh, my Lord.
Hi.
That is so wonderful.
Yes,
this is awesome. Y'all have put something together here, man. I ain't gonna go nowhere. I'm gonna stay here for 100. I'm gonna be here for 100, so we can meet again.
I've got a question for Brother Hearn. Do we have the ability to snap a photo in Zoom?
Brother, let me see what I can do here for us.
Yeah, maybe later when we have maybe right before we start the video.
Okay. All right.
That's
you getting it?
Oh, it's so good.
Yes, ma'am. How you doing?
Wow.
Yes, ma'am.
Isn't it just so extraordinary? Look at Kara. I remember, what was that, Monroe School? What was that school that Megan, you were running things over there? You remember that? Megan, you were in charge.
They called themselves.
This is.
I'll take all the
way over. Yes. Yes. Uh-huh. Yeah, wow, this is so wonderful. Some brothers. So Justin, yeah, it's a three now, right?
Yep, it's three. Yeah, they're playing with they're playing with their cousins right now. So I've had a little time in the house to just kind of do things that need to be fixed and little stuff like that. So they're happy playing with their cousins and I'm just fixing everything that's been, sort of turned over here since we all been home in the house for a year. So.
Oh, yeah. That's wonderful.
It really
yes.
Is. Uh-huh. But it's a blessing to see everybody and just glad to see you. Right. Pastor Wood.
Thank you.
Yes, to be here.
We moved here 16 years ago, and it's been a good journey. And to be here in the same city with the Monroes,
yeah,
and all of that, the good Lord has just been so good.
It's a long ride.
Yeah.
And Brother Cecil Carter from Florida.
That's right. I'm here. Lisa. Happy birthday, Uncle Lisa. Michael.
Lisa. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my God.
Happy birthday.
Oh, my God.
Happy birthday. You're looking absolutely wonderful, all three of you. So good to see you.
Thank you.
Oh, good thank to see you.
Oh, my Lord.
Cecil, you're doing thank you there.
Yes.
Say that again.
From Florida.
Yes, Fort Myers.
That's Fort right. Myers. Oh, you're looking wonderful, Cecil.
Well, thank you. You're kind. You're looking great.
Yeah, we're making it.
Oh, yeah. All right. Very good.
Yes,
very good. Indeed. You know, I was thinking about something. Isabel and I were down in Naples all day today. We were celebrating our basically 16th anniversary.
Wonderful.
We met on April the 6th.
Wow. Oh, my goodness.
Years ago. And I remember Uncle Virgil telling me some time ago that life was going to get good to me after I passed 50. And he was right about that.
That's right.
Oh, that's right.
And see, so yeah. Immediately above you is Dr. Owen Codwell, who's colleague now with your friend, Dr. John, from UVA and now at Lynchburg College.
Okay, Roger Jones, Dr. Codwell, how are you, sir?
Good, Brother Carter. How are you?
So nice to meet you.
Yeah, Roger is my dean and good friend.
Okay, well, you be sure to give Roger my regards. We were in Charlottesville together. We worked very closely together and became very good friends.
I'll do that.
Yes. You're at Lynchburg College with him.
Yeah. Yeah.
Lynchburg University. Okay.
Question. Dr. Wood, we've got a Pastor Ratliff on as well.
Oh, whoa, my
Pastor Joe!
Yeah, yeah, Betty. Oh, you're coming to help us celebrate.
Dr. Joseph Radliff.
Right.
Man, you've been preaching your hips off through this thing here, man. Yeah. We wouldn't miss it.
That's right.
What a blessing. What a blessing.
Yes,
Dr. Radliff, you're on mute.
You're dead. You're mute.
Okay. Yeah. There you go. Is that it? Good. I'm technically challenged, so I mean you have to understand.
Nothing's gonna stop you now. I know that. I know that. Listen, thank you so much for what you've been doing during this pandemic on Sunday morning.
God bless you. God bless you. Thank you all for viewing. Thank you.
Yes, major blessing.
Yeah.
And there's Brother David Duke over there. Hey, Brother David.
Hey, Duke. Yeah, Rhode Island.
Oh, my God.
Oh, happy birthday, Pastor Woods. Happy birthday.
Thank you so much.
Oh, good to see you, Sister Woods.
Yeah, good to see you too, David. Yes, you and Sharon.
Uh-huh. Doc, we got another Eta Rho Sigma member as well, Brother Naylor.
Naylor.
Hey, Brother Naylor.
Naylor.
You know that, right?
Yes. Oh, Donald.
Yeah, you know his wife.
Yes. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yes. Brother Donald. Uh-huh.
This is great.
Donald, you're on mute.
Yes, Carl Moses.
Yeah, Brother Carl Moses.
Yes. All right. And who else is that connected?
Joey. That is another Eta Rho Sigma. Joe Roland is on now. Joe Roland.
Hey, just want to wish you a happy birthday.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you, Brother Joe. This is so thoughtful of y'all to do this for this old
man. Oh, man, well deserved.
Thank you. Thank you.
I recognize Brother Reggie Thomas. Is that Reggie? Brother Thomas?
That's me.
That's right. Ooh. There we go. More Eta Rho Sigma here.
Hey, Brother Reggie.
Hey.
Okay.
Wonderful. This Eta Rho crowd, man. You want them on your side.
Well, you wait till you see this video. Wait till you see the video.
Now, would y'all promise me that y'all would get back with me 10 years from now?
You got it.
No. I tell you what. It may be at a different place. Maybe that's not the thing to ask.
Happy As birthday, Cooper Uncle said, Virgil. Wait till you see the video.
Where's Tanya and Phil?
Hello?
Dr. Phil Wood? And Tanya.
Hi, Virgil. Happy birthday.
Oh, hi. Yeah, Phil. Yeah. Greetings, my brother.
This is Phil Hart coming to you from Los Angeles via Roxbury.
Yeah, that's right. We go way back, Phil. We go way back. Oh, that is just so wonderful.
Dr. Wood?
Yay.
You said 10 years from now, Cooper gave you some good prophetic advice. Wait till you listen to the video.
Okay.
Especially one that somebody might be talking to you now. put out?
Oh, somebody, we're missing that. Oh, well, we can't.
Yeah, Dr. Lee.
No, you got to put it
closer. Put it forward. Okay, pull it.
That's right. Yeah, that's
it. How you doing, Dr. Lee?
That's good. Okay. Pull it forward.
Yeah, that's
it. All right, that better.
Happy birthday, Uncle Roger from the Brown family. It's Rhonda Brown. Can you see me?
Oh, Rhonda.
Hi. Rhonda.
Hi.
Where are your pretty face? Where are your pretty face?
I'm right here.
Where, Rhonda?
I'm right here.
Right
I'll
there.
Keep talking.
Rhonda. Hey, Rhonda.
Hi, how are you?
Yeah.
You oh, came my goodness.
Texas and Georgia. Did you
I
like
sure
it?
I sure did. I had a good time. I love seeing my cousin Deborah. Yeah. Happy birthday. You look so
yeah.
beautiful.
Yeah.
You do.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Represent. Oh, yeah.
Berger, can you recognize this? Can you see that?
Wait a minute. Where was that?
I feel like I am.
Somebody just I'm said.
Just, wow. I'm just trying to show you your book. I got oh, yeah. your book right here.
Your book.
I'm so grateful.
Oh, Brother Lee, that Dr. Lee down there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Hey,
hey,
yes, sir. Yes, this is so. No, this is just oh, extraordinary. Yeah. This is so wonderful.
Oh, this is beautiful. All of that. Yeah, there's your book. See, he's got your.
Oh,
book.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, I just want you to know it. I got your book.
All right.
Been reading it too.
And give me some feedback.
Yes, I will.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
Right.
This is just extraordinary. I'm so yeah. thrilled. Yes. You know, if it weren't for pandemic, I don't think all of us could have gotten together. There's right. some blessings anyway, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah. Yes. Oh. See, if the best kiss you can get is on the telephone, take it. I heard a preacher do that with Brother Joe. He was saying yeah. someone's like getting a kiss on the telephone. And I thought at that time, you know, that wasn't such a good idea. But, you know, getting together yes. with physical distance can still have spiritual intimacy.
That's yeah, that's yeah, true.
We can
that's
be intimate because yeah. of the spirit.
That's, right. that's great. Yeah. That's great.
Just wonderful. So just love you all so much.
Zach, you want to take... You want to take the first photo? We can have more, but we can take a photo now before we start our video.
Okay, come closer.
Right, you want to take?
Right, who? Anyone who wants to be a part of the photo, you can turn your camera on. And my wonderful wife has skills with that as well. I believe.
Oh.
You can grab one as well. There we go. Uh-huh. And I believe Brother Hearn.
So we can get you in.
Where is Brother Hearn?
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah.
A little endeavor. Right. Are you able to set it up on your side too?
Yes, sir. I'm setting it up right now.
Okay, all right. So.
Wait, let me take my glasses off.
You good idea, Jeremy. Yeah.
Just all right. Mm-hmm.
So we're on the count of three, everybody, big smiles. One, two.
Here we get
cheese,
it.
Cheese.
Yes. Got it. Yeah.
And Dante, you got yours too? All right. I think we're good. Are we
yeah.
Are we just about ready to premiere the video, Brother Hearn?
Yes, sir, we are. Let me ask everyone, if you're not muted, to go ahead and mute yourself with Dr. Wood.
A mute?
Okay. No, okay. No, Dr. Wood, leave yourself unmuted, just in case you want to get feedback.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to share the screen, and our numbers are climbing here, folks. We got about almost 30 people on the call.
Wow. We'll have more time to chat after the video. It's about 20 minutes long, so... Not too long, and then we'll have time to chat again, Dr. Wood.
Okay, that's great.
All right, so I'm gonna share my screen here, guys. This is it, yes, sir. Can you all see my screen?
Yes. Wow. Here
we
look
go.
At that.
Wow.
But it was
surprise. Oh. Isn't that amazing? Oh my God. Oh my God.
Yeah. Wow. Down in Birmingham.
Yeah.
Oh, my Lord.
Mm-hmm. From Nayla to every
brother, Dr. Virgil Wood. Happy, happy birthday, my brother. I'm Brother Chris Ray, current International First Vice President of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated. On behalf of Michael E. Crystal, our 35th International President, the General Board of Phi Beta Sigma, and all Sigma men worldwide, first and foremost, thank you. Thank you for dedicating your life to serve others, to serve humanity, and to make this world a better place. May you have a phenomenal 90th birthday, because everything that you receive today is well-deserved. Thank you for empowering generations of us to understand that we must continue to make life a little bit better for the next generation. Thank you, Brother Wood, for just being who you are. God bless you, and may God continue to strengthen you to be an inspiration for others. Goodbye now.
This is Edwin Miles, the 15th Gulf Coast Regional Director, wishing you a happy 90th birthday and congratulating you on 9 decades of culture for service and service to humanity. I hope and wish that you have many more.
Hi, I'm Howard Redman, Gulf Coast Regional Director of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity. Today, we would like to honor and recognize Brother Dr. Woods on his 90th birthday. Brother Woods, you've done a great job providing leadership to our communities and being a civil rights activist. Take a day, take a break, enjoy your day. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Happy birthday, Dr. Woods, and I wish you many, many more. James Cheatham of the NRO Sigma Chapter.
Greetings, Dr. Woods. My name is Jackie Wallace. I am the president of the Eta Rho Sigma Chapter of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated. On behalf of the executive board and the chapter, I would like to wish you a happy 90th birthday. You, sir, are a living legend. The work that you've done in the community through activism, the mentorship that you have provided to young men and women will forever be appreciated. You, sir, are a living legend. I pray that you and your family enjoy this special day. We look forward to celebrating you and celebrating with you. Again, happy 90th birthday.
Greetings, our dear brother and friend, Dr. Virgil Wood. This is Brother Paris Taylor, the current first vice president for the Eta Rho Sigma chapter of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated. On behalf of our chapter, I extend to you a happy 90th birthday. As we celebrate this special birthday with you, Dr. Wood, we ask that you slow down a bit and enjoy a special day. So much for being an example to us in our chapter of your lifelong work, your commitment and contributions to society. You definitely exemplify the fraternity's model, culture for service and service for humanity. Happy 90th birthday again, and thank you so much, brother. Enjoy your day.
Dr. Wood, turning 90 is an extraordinary landmark. Pivoting into the age of 90 is like a graduation. You've stepped up in the world with more years under your belt and more wisdom in your soul. So many seasons, so much change. What a blessing. From the stories I have heard you share, you've witnessed incredible things over 9 decades while participating and experiencing many remarkable events. These stories reflect a life well lived. Since meeting you, I must say, your energy has inspired me. You have reached this incredible peak, bursting with zest and vigor. And you continue to move at full speed ahead like a race car or a fast jet. Your engines are revving and ready to go forward. Just like wine, some things get finer with age. A standing ovation is in order, and I present you
with a virtual toast to another year of good health and great times. My wish for you is that you cross new paths, venture into unknown territories, and embrace every change and continue to create stories, new and old. I'll see you at 100. I wish you the happiest and greatest of birthdays ever.
Thank you.
Good morning, Dr. Wood. Johnny Sandals here. On the occasion of your 90th birthday in this world of ours, I'd just like to give you another word of encouragement and a heartfelt thanks for the many years that you've put in for the struggle for our people. Your work with Dr. King over the years, and then in the latter years since you've been welcomed into back to Sigma here in the Greater Houston area, has been a joy to work with you over these years. I remember that Sunday when you were preaching at Winds Village, and you were just so captivated.
Mm.
Oh, I said, man, I gotta meet this man. I know that you were a Sigma man at the time, and I didn't make the connection, even though I'd known your daughter for many years. Took me a while, and then I made the connection. And when I found out that you were Sigma, I said, oh, you got to come, you got to be in our chapter. And so it's been a joy for the years to share it with us, the Native of Sigma, and that powerful speech, Conclave Detroit, I'll never forget that. I've never been prouder as a Sigma man that I was that day when you changed the narrative. And it's one thing I know, the Honorable John Lewis would not be in the Distinguished Service Chapter if it wasn't for your efforts of that day. And the many years and the amount of service that he had put in, and people were still keeping him out. And that day got him into the Distinguished Service Chapter along with Jonathan Mason. So that this one shining moment that I know you'll have in your memory as you go forward is that you did something good for 587 that day. Happy birthday, Dr. Wood. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Wow, Johnny, that was beautiful.
Happy 90th birthday, Dr. Wood. This is your friend, Ramsey Cooper, your fraternity brother. I am so glad to be able to celebrate this day with you, and thankful that you are a member of Phi Beta Sigma fraternity. I want to just show you here, you may not be aware, but I have a shelf dedicated on my bookshelf to books that you have introduced me to, starting with the book that you co-produced, you produced, which being the African-American Jubilee Bible, which you led the effort that wrote the essays about the African-American history at the very beginning, which it takes up right around 300 pages. You know that information, but for anyone who doesn't know, but the African-American Jubilee Bible is right here.
Mm-hmm.
In that direction or the other books that you have introduced me to. Some have come directly from the authors who would, I would be surprised by going to the mail. I'd have a book in the mail from the author himself that sent it to me because I know you, and you suggested that he send the book to his colleagues that he wanted an opinion on. And so I'm speechless when that happens, and I'm thankful to you for that. I can also share a quick story. If you recall, in Detroit, when we traveled together to Conclave in 2017, you made that speech on Conclave 4. And right before you did so, we sat down together and you were sharing with me that you were sensing a burning, a fire within, a passion within, and you compared it to a flame. and you indicated it's not a red flame, it's a blue flame, and which is hotter than red. And you just felt that passion right before you went and spoke. You had asked me right before how to conclude your speech. You asked me, Brother Cooper, should I finish my speech by saying blue five? And I said, Dr. Wood, now don't do that. You don't have to do that. But you went, you delivered that passionate speech, and because you so electrified the conclave floor, you didn't have to say it. The brothers said it.
Who did? So did. The
conclave yelled out blue five.
Yes, yes.
You know, Dr. Wood, you did that. And it is memorable to me and made such an impact for so many. We are thankful for you, and we hope that you enjoy this day. That comes from me and also comes from my family as well, which you have been so meaningful to as well. So again, Dr. Wood, enjoy it today and take a break. We know you don't take a day off, but take a day off and relax and enjoy your birthday. Have a great one.
Virgil Woods, Jonathan Mason here.
Oh my God.
First of all, let me apologize for my disheveled look. Today we've been working, we're doing some renovations here at the church, and I've been lifting and hauling, but Brother Cooper told me I needed to get this video in today, so I did not want to take a chance in missing an opportunity to say to you happy 90th birthday. Happy 90th lap around the sun. Sir, you have been a blessing to so many. You've been a blessing to our people. You've been a blessing to our fraternity. And you've been a blessing to me personally. Let me tell you, the first time I met you, it was a reception for me in Texas, one of the brothers' homes.
Right.
When they introduced me to you, it stopped being about a reception for me, and it became an opportunity for me to sit at your feet and to learn. I enjoyed the conversation so much that we've developed a friendship that lasts to this day. I enjoy getting your emails. I enjoy getting your phone calls. I enjoy calling you.
Thank you.
You've introduced me to some wonderful people, sir. And let me say this to you. You have come to Philadelphia right here to the Northeast Baptist Church. And you bless my people.
Amen.
You hug on my children. You signed books that they still bring and show us today. They still talk about you, man. Listen, it is my prayer that God keeps you in perfect health.
Thank you.
And he keeps you in sound mind.
Yes, yes.
There are so many that still need to hear your story.
Yes.
To hear your testimony.
Hallelujah.
As long as you're living, don't you ever silence yourself. You tell
people.
Tell people not only did you march with civil rights icons, but you are a civil rights icon.
Wow.
And we're able to do a lot of what we do today because of men and women like you. I will never forget how to play in Detroit 2017. Some of the brothers were trying to give me, after 4 years of office, a little going away present. But you stood up to that microphone and you spoke. You spoke to 2,000 plus Sigma men and you told them, do the right thing. And you moved that entire delegation. Photo of you standing at that mic, sir, is iconic. As a matter of fact, as I think about it, I'm going to pull that photo today from my favorites. You know, we don't print pictures anymore for some reason. We just look at them on our phone. But I'm going to pull that phone and I'm going to frame it. Let me tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to put it right up there. See, that's my dad back there in those blue shots. That's his wall. But I'm going to, let me go over here. That shot over there is me at the Charles I. Brown dedication when we found our founder, history. The middle portion is the presidential seal. That's a photo I got in Korea. Those are all some things that mean a lot to me. I've never put another picture on my dad's wall. You can't see the third picture because of the door. I'm putting you on my dad's wall. That's what I'm becoming. I want to be with you together every day I walk in. Thank you for your friendship. Thank you for your brotherhood. Thank you for the sacrifices you made. And may God continue to bless and keep you as you continue to be a blessing to others.
Praise God. Oh, praise God. That's where we're at. That's that Detroit meeting you're talking
about.
Yes,
I know you told me.
Yeah.
What
you was doing to him. Yes. Wow. Yes, Brother Colin.
Happy birthday, Dr. Virgil Wood. This is Carl Byrne, your Hetero Sigma chapter brother and your mentee. I thank you for taking me under your wing, taking the time to pour into me love, encouragement, and wisdom. And so today, we pause to celebrate a young man who is 90 years young, a young man who is a great trailblazer, civil rights activist, most of all, a wonderful humanitarian and a great brother. And thank you again for all that you do. And we want you to take a little break as we give you your flowers while you are yet here on this side to receive them. Continue to do great things and continue to enjoy your special day. We love you and we thank God for you. And may God bless you on your special day.
All right. Now, Dr. Wood, we have to give a lot of credit to Brother Hearn. He pulled that together for us. Mm-hmm. And right now, I want to let you know that we do have the 34th International President of Phi Beta Sigma on the call right now. Brother Mason is with us. Brother Mason.
Dr. Wood, happy birthday, sir. Happy birthday to you, man. Listen, you know my level of respect and admiration and appreciation for you.
That
goes without saying. I'm actually in Virginia. I'm going to see your good friend, Dr. Cardwell, hopefully tomorrow or Friday. I see him on the call. I've been sending him pictures today, all the fish we've been catching, so he knows that we're going to fry something up for him. but I took a break from the pool, from the pond, fishing with my boys. I just wanted to be on this call tonight, this Zoom, just to experience this with the Brotherhood. So it's their opportunity. Ramsey played my whole speech to you, so I'm not going to take up a whole lot of time. I want them to be able to speak to you. But you know I love you dearly. It's so good to see your wife there with you in the picture. Man, keep doing what you do. Keep getting in, as John Lewis said, good trouble. Keep shaking up the norms. And as you said to me before, and they just have to bleep me, I'm sorry, we need to keep keeping these Negroes straight. And make sure they do the right thing. All right, so, and I'm not going to say what you said clean on your 90th birthday, but look, we got folks going in the right direction, because unless we stand for somebody, until, and I say this all the time, until everybody has a seat at the table of success, none of us have a seat at the table of success. And so I want to thank you for all that you've done. I'm done. I want to hear the other brothers give you your tributes. You and I will talk more. And probably Dr. Cardwell and I'll give you a call when he comes over here while I'm here in town.
My Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Oh, got that Brother Bert Milton, another Sigma brother there. And Leo, Brother Roseburg, see you. Oh, we have Maya. That's my
it. I'm here. Dr. Woods, this is Brother Leo Roseburg. I would like to extend a very happy birthday to you, and your lovely wife is there to support you. And the brothers of Alpha Beta Sigma chapter extend their well wishes also. I'm a youngster, So my civil rights period came during the Newark riots, and it was tough then and it's tough now. And we will continue to fight on. And so thank you so much for all that you've done and will continue to do. Thank you, sir.
I know his wife, Kate.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. This is a gathering that was made in heaven. And here we are rejoicing in each other's presence. I want you to know that Sigma taught me, took up where my daddy left off, how to be what I like to now call a Jubilee man. A Jubilee man is a good shepherd. He's a good shepherd. He provides and protects all that God puts under his care, starting with his own family. And then the other families that we adopt and adopt us. And I want you to know that at this stage of my life, God has me involved in some of the most important things I have ever done. And I'll tell you very quickly what it is. If we don't know how to turn the children on to love of life and the old folks, we've missed everything. We've got to work at saving every child. I don't care what they look like. I don't care what their circumstances are. We must save every child on planet Earth, because God says, I don't like it if you hinder the children. I'm going to let you drown in the ocean. We got to save every child. And then we got to honor the old people so that the young people and the old people get on a platform of love and respect. Once they fall in love with one another, children will learn things early in life that sometimes they pay too dear a price to learn late in life. There's some things that I'm learning right now. I'm still learning right now at 90. I could have known if I was 19 if anybody had been teaching it. So let's make sure that the children stop ending their own lives before they live. Suicide among babies. Jesus looked at the mothers and said, don't weep for me. Weep for yourselves. Weep for your babies. Let's weep for the babies and then make this world what it needs to be. I believe God will use us to make America do what Martin used to say, just do what you put on paper. And I'm so grateful to my dear friend, Brother Ramsey, and to every one of you for giving us this opportunity to be present to each other again. Please, so just stop. Women always try to tell you what to do.
Doc, we have another special guest for you. We have the Congresswoman on with us.
Wow.
We have, Dr. Wood, we have Congresswoman Sheba Jackson Lee.
My favorite. Where's Sister Sheila? Sister Sheila Jackson Lee.
Okay, Dr. Wood, we also have another special guest. While Congresswoman is coming on, I'm going to ask that the Honorable Dr. Elwin Lee share a few words for us and with Thank us, you. And we'll be followed by Congresswoman Sheba Jackson Lee.
Wow. Well, Dr. Wood, I would have spoken earlier, and Carl has caused me to break a family rule. Mm. You know the old saying, ladies first? Well,
yes.
But definitely the queen in my house would go first, and I wasn't going to speak before her because she told me she was calling in.
Right.
So I may have to get a whipping for speaking first. But let me just say that I didn't write anything down because I wanted to absorb what was going on in this great celebration of your life and speak somewhat spontaneously. My first thought in watching you and your wife is it God knows black don't crack. My Amen. Goodness, dude, you all you look young.
Good
you all look so young.
Thank you.
My second thought is, if you got the energy to write another book, you need to write the book that talks about how the two of you are so young and energetic. I'm sure there's secrets there that we need to follow. That's the second thing I thought.
Yeah.
And the third thing, And I'm just speaking spontaneous. I want to thank you for your book. I was recently ask to write a prayer to for my reunion at Yale that's coming up this month. They have a recorded service of 30 minutes. And I used to be a deacon in the church back there, but some of those people who were deacons have gone on to be reverends. And and so why they asked me, I'm not sure. But I suspect they wanted some diversity. But in any event, I said yes. And as I went to do this, I was rummaging around trying to find out how am I going to do this? You know, I got all these pastors part of the group. And so I went to your book and I found my inspiration in reading some of the words in your book, In Love We Trust. And so I was able to craft a prayer that passed their review and said some meaningful things about you know, there's still work to be done, and to challenge them to engage in that work. And I want to thank you for being a living example of how to live your life and how to continue in the fight. I noticed in the documentary or the video, where so many times, you know, you could feel the fire in your body, and you had your two-inch cliffs, you know, which emphasized how important it was to you, but not only that you were fighting for something, you know. We need people who have that fire and ability, because God knows we have challenges these days. And the other thing, you know, I've heard you talk, and we've talked, and you talked about how this world needs to come together. And because we got a lot of challenges, and with climate change and the pandemic and all these shootings, if we don't come together, well, I think you said we may drown in the ocean. I don't know. We may burn up in the California fires or the Texas droughts or the Texas winter storms, suffer through that. But we need to get it together now. I'm told. Yes, we do. So I thank you for bringing that message every time you talk. You know, you bring it forcefully. And now tonight you've emphasized how we need to not forget the children. I think that's very important. Sometimes I think we as Black people don't do enough for the children, you know? And if we don't get to them early, it's hard to get to them later, you know? Generally, when the kids are small, they look, I thought about George Floyd. Yes, and if you've seen some of the pictures of him when he was a boy, he was smiling and full of hope. And then you see later, I ask myself, why did it seem like his only choices seemed to be the basketball or football? And he grew up over in the CUNY homes, just across the street almost from the University of Houston, not far from where I grew up. And why were those the only choices, seemingly, you know? Why did we as a village, as a community, as whole, I felt like we failed him. Yeah. A lady from the Washington Post came down to do a story on the CUNY home. And she contacted me, and I put in touch with a few people. But in the end, and I'm going to find a way to send you this story, she focused on a woman who lived in the CUNY homes, and she had a son. And this woman was trying mightily to save her son so that he won't get into negative things. And so she did all kinds of things and sacrifice. And in the story, he's about to go off to junior college. And someone asked him at a store, right at the end of this article, said, well, what's your major? And he said, well, my major is football. Mm-hmm. He says, what's your well, what's your minor? He said, basketball. And then the cashier said, what if those don't work? And he drew a blank. And that's so many years after George Floyd, and there we are. I wonder what will become of him if those don't pan out, you know. And I blame it, I blame the community if we don't wrap our arms around
them and
create the options and get involved with them. You know, because I often think that because the sports are so ubiquitous, people want to become the things that they see. And where are the people that they see? I recently saw a show about making Black male doctors. And they talked about such a low percentage of the doctors are Black male doctors. And they emphasize in the show, there's these two doctors and they got this nonprofit and they're trying to go out, encourage young Black boys and Black families to raise a doctor. And how you got to get to them early and then you get around them people who are doctors or who know about medical stuff. Because other families, you know, are intentional. You look at the Asian community.
That's right.
It's almost automatic. I've been at the University of Houston a long time, and we got tons of Asians here. And when they walk in, you can almost guarantee they're majoring in some science, going to be an engineer, a pharmacist, or a doctor. And that didn't just happen. They intentionally, you know, drum that into their heads early, to the point where they think it was their idea. I'm not saying you have to be that, but I've also met brothers who have asked what they want to be and they can't throw a football or dribble. You know what they say? I'm going to be a sportscaster. Mm-hmm. And I said, well, okay, that's an idea. But if you heard the people saying that talk, you would say, where did he get that idea?
Mm-hmm. You know?
Anyway, I'm going on. Now it looks like I'm preaching, and I'm not a preacher. But anyway, I just want to say your fire and motivation and vigor is an inspiration to people like me who have a backache that's hurting. I'm gonna try to overcome it, and I look forward to your book. Don't take too long to write it, though, okay?
I'm working on it now.
That's great. And so happy 90th birthday to you. I think everybody on the call is inspired by the life you've lived, and that's great. The other thing I want to say, it's so wonderful to see a Black couple that is so happy together. You know, when you look at TV these days, you see any shows with Black couples on it? You see a lot of commercials got mixed race couples and all of that.
Yes, Lord.
You notice, everybody's been noticing how that's... that's a thing on the television these days.
Right.
Well, somebody told me, well, television getting liberal. Well, somebody else mentioned that maybe they're just trying to get rid of us. Because many people do not know that schools are now required to have a category called, multiracial.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so what happens when they list their students, it's like Hispanic, Black, multiracial. So the Black category is going down. Many of the people in the multiracial would have been Black, you see, in the years past. And so it looks like there's not as many Black people. So someone suggested that, well, maybe it's just trying to get rid of us in some sense by having this redefining things. So anyway, it's a lot going on, and it's so wonderful to see y'all are an inspiration, because you don't see that very much.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Lee, for your wise words
and
for your well wishes. Dr. Wood, we have with us and everybody the hardest working congresswoman in the United States Congress. She fights for the people and is no stranger to doing the right thing. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce the Honorable Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee from the U.S. House of Representatives from the 18th Congressional District of Texas.
Thank you so very much.
That's wonderful.
My dear brother. I hope you can see me. Can you all see me?
Yes.
We're sort of makeshifting here because I'm moving around, but I hope you can see a portion thereof of me. And I can see your beautiful family. Beautiful bride, and as they say, there's a special good looking lady in the back there, my sister, that just decided to lean over. How are you?
Yeah, you see it.
Dr. Woods, you're peering. Can you see me? Am I showing up?
Yes, indeed.
You can see me?
Yes.
Okay, there I am. I'm trying to makeshift here so you can see me. Mm-hmm. All right. There I am.
You got it.
What a wonderful celebration. Thank you, Carl, and all those who came on. I did not want to miss this opportunity. Carl gave me the opportunity to do a video, and I hope that he is capturing this so that, though I didn't do the video, I hope this will be on streaming or captured for you, because you are so deserving of this. And I wanted to take a moment. Let me thank my husband. It's not often that I get him to acknowledge maybe I should go first. And I said that he should go first. He did a stupendous job. Yes, and I told him that he would be, he did. I told him that he would be far more eloquent than I would be. But I wanted to take this opportunity because Dr. Woods, you have blessed us. Sister Woods, if I may call her that, and her beauty.
Yes, indeed.
By being in the midst of us and reminding us. And so I've taken the time to try and pull some things that I would like to wrap and wind in my tribute to you tonight. First of all, I want to acknowledge to everyone, and sometimes the life and legacy does not get planted in the seeds of the minds of those whose generational time frame may be limited to a certain window of time. And they may be good. I mean, hip hop is something I know that you, I know Dr. Woods, you probably just love hip hop. And you love gospel, and you love rock, and you love soul. But the people who come in those moments, they don't know the elongation of your life. Mm-hmm. And I think it is important in this tribute to understand why you are constantly a scholar and writing and trying to encourage people, because you've had the experiences that so many of us would envy. So I am reminded of this time when the governor, lieutenant governor, can get up and call those of us who oppose voter suppression tomfoolery, mm-hmm. and that we are foolish and we don't know what we're talking about. Mm-hmm. When I can articulate for you the very aspects of the Georgia bill and the Senate Bill 7, and I can tell you that they speak nothing more than suppression and oppression. Yes, you'll be able to speak to us about that. And so Dr. King, as he was, there are many moments in his life, but he said this, it was in the face of the racism of Governor Wallace, who you know was born again and changed his mind, but he told him, Dr. King said, that we are not about to turn around. We are on the move. Mm-hmm. Yes, we are on the move, and no wave of racism can stop us now. More than almost 50 years ago that was said, you, the wise man, have continued to remind us that, in fact, we were on the move. We continue to be on the move. We can be on the move. We have the skills to be on the move. Nothing is going to turn us around, even in the face of racism. And here we are in 2021, when we were on the move. We had a movement under Obama in terms of believing that we were just invincible. Of course, we had a wake-up call for 4 years, and the ugly scab of America became glaringly in our face. But the point is, Dr. Woods, you continue to remind us of this in your speeches. I've taken a look at some of the videos in your speeches about the fact that I think you even told us that this you sort of predicted here where we are, but all that jubilee, 8 years, and then this election, and here we have not only a pandemic of COVID-19, a pandemic of racism, of voter suppression. And reminded, you often say, if I have it right, that we should be a community of learning and that we should be constantly learning. I pay tribute to you for that, because we should listen. I think when you stop opening a book and stop reading and stop listening and stop learning and stop asking questions, then you lose your way. And I'm trying to cite the speech that you did where you talked about the Lynching Improvement Association. I think it was Service, Learning, and Community, and Martin Luther King's real mission. And you talked about Dr. Howard Stevenson and creating a culture. And so my point today is to pay tribute to a civil rights giant that is still on the battlefield and still has the wisdom to be able to, as Elwin said, show this loving relationship with your bride, to be part of a wonderful family and to have your faculties about you. My grandmother said, I woke up in my right mind.
Amen.
I don't say that to you, Doc, because there's some of us who are 22 and got to be grateful that we have awakened in our right mind.
That's right. Amen.
The young man that perpetrated this act on last Friday, Good Friday, was 25. And he made the point, attacked the Capitol Hill police officers, killed one. We mourn his passing. And his family said he had mental health issues. And so we know that as a people, there is a time now in history that we can't go back. We're on the move, but we cannot go forward if we're not learning and listening, and that we don't find a Dr. Virgil Woods and not only celebrate his birthday, but say, Doc, tell us where we should go, how we should go, what's the pathway we should take. And Doc, we should form this think tank that you're talking about, because people should understand what that means. It means that we will be prepared for each moment in history where they try to turn us around and turn us back.
Amen.
I'm listening to you. My tribute is I will be a listener and a learner of Dr. Virgil Woods. I will be someone who is always eager to understand what is the next pathway I should take. How do I deal with a Governor Abbott who wants to not throw out the ball in an overcrowded stadium in the first place? They shouldn't have been up there in the stadium in the first place, but he's going to make a point that he's not throwing out the ball because he's against our being against voter suppression. I tell you what, Sister Woods, I don't let any of that turn me around.
That's right.
I don't even waste time with trying to
pay
attention to people who are misguided and don't understand. So Dr. Woods, this day is your day. You reminded me of John Robert Lewis, but I should say that he reminded me of Dr. Virgil Woods. And everybody should know that you were a young pastor with Dr. King.
Yes. It was
something that we had to make up, because you said he was a chain smoker and he loved ham hops and soul food. I know you were around Dr. King. Because most people saw the erudite spokesperson for the people at Riverside Church and beyond, but you understood the man. And you could absorb both his intellect and his humanity. And so today, I just want to say to you that we're recognizing your intellect, your genius, but also your humanity. Your passion as a husband, as a father, and as someone who wants to guide his people to a place better than you were able to find. For living 90 years, you came to this world that none of us could ever imagine. You saw the likes of the World War, ending of World War I, the collapse, the financial collapse, the depression, folks standing out with apples. You lived through all of that and lived through it in a way that your genius was beyond your status, if you will. But look who you are today. You understood FDR, who never really did anything. He opened up the country for poor people. But we still stood second class, even under a great president like Franklin Delano Roosevelt, even under a great president like Truman. And you lived under that. Does everybody understand that?
Yes, Lord.
And so my words are simply to you, not that you have no life. It is that you have life and that your deeds will always follow you. And they are present for us today to imitate, emulate, and to understand. And your voice is here for us today. So Carla's given me this opportunity to pay tribute. I always say that no officialdom was needed for this celebration of a hero of all of ours, a 90-day American icon. No official presence of a member of the United States Congress, but it is my honor and privilege to be able to be a small part of that celebration of a gentleman who's had a journey through ages and still can tell the story. This is your story. I all love that song, Blessed Assurance. This is my story. And this is your story.
Yes.
Never let it be quashed. Never let your voice be silenced. Let the words continue. Speak into a tape recorder, or iPhone, and tell us everything so we'll have these precious pearls on and on and on. And I would only say that I will continue to be reminded of all that you've encouraged us and the beauty of your life, the message of your words, and the story of genius and freedom and justice. You're a freedom fighter, my friend, 90 years, and that intellect will never be silenced. So it is for me to say that as I close my tribute, you are truly, on behalf of the United States Congress and the 18th Congressional District, deserving of the commendation, respect, and admiration of the United States of America. With the power invested in me, I have the authority to say that this day is Dr. Virgil Woods Day in the 18th Congressional District, April 6, 2021. God bless you and God bless this wonderful family. Love you dearly and God bless the United States of America. Thank you all. Thank you, Carl, for yielding to me.
Thank you, Congresswoman. And we're going to ask that everyone join us for a brief virtual photo with Dr. Wood and Congresswoman Lee in front.
How do we do that?
Everybody turn on their cameras and look into your camera and smile, and I'm going to count you down. We're going to take two photos.
Okay.
Okay, here we go, guys. All right. Here we go. First photo. 1, 2, and 3. Second photo. 1, 2, and 3. And let me scroll over to the second page of participants. And I'll count you down once more and we will be done. 1, 2, and 3. And one more. 1, 2, and 3. Congresswoman Lee, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank everybody. Thank you very much.
I would like to say, Congresswoman, you know, my admiration for you is deep. And as we think about the late Thomas Freeman,
yes.
He and I are products of two of the same schools, Virginia Union and Andover Newton Theological. And that great train that leads down through Sister Barbara Jordan,
yeah.
down through Mickey Leland, and now you carrying on, and you are doing work that will help us save the nation and save ourselves. We must save America to save ourselves. Yes. We will not save ourselves if we don't work to save America also. And your work is so just, we just love it when we see you taking care of business in Washington. You have our deepest admiration and gratitude. I want to say also, I'm just delighted my great grandbabies are on. We've been on with us tonight. There they are, Michaela and Isaiah, and their proud grandpa, our son David, and of course Deborah has been putting this whole thing. She and Brother Ramsey have been working, and they've been bossing me around all day. I could be pleased, Deborah. I know what I'm doing. Please, these women, y'all know what's going on here. I want to express my deepest gratitude to each of you and to Brother Ramsey and Brother Carl for making this happen. What has happened here tonight often takes months and months to bring together. And here you have made it happen in this moment. And here's what I want to say. Let's be clear. America is at a place now where nobody else knows what to do. Nobody else. Black folks at our best. that's Clyburn and Sister Shield and all the rest. We got to figure out how do we lead now? How do we lead as a people? Lift our people from the bottom, those who don't know what to do, don't know who they are. We've got to work among them. We got young George Floyd's out there. We make all this to do at George Floyd's funeral and didn't do much. He was literally chased out of Houston. We should know that. He was chased out of Houston. And before we celebrate his birthday another October, let's find out where his children are. Make sure, I happen to know that one of his boys, we just got to wake up and stop putting on shows for the television with these funerals and things and get real and give our children a reason to hold their heads up and to know that they can stand toe-to-toe with anybody else. And I just believe that when Black folks get ready to get serious, we're going to build new settlements in America that links urban and rural. So there was a little boy in grade school and the teacher said, "What are you doing, Johnny?" He says, "I'm trying to learn how to build cities and run things, not just looking for somebody to give them a job. They'll create jobs. That's what we got to do." And we've been blessed by people in our lives. I'll tell you, Daddy King was one of our biggest mentors, Benjamin Mays, Sam Proctor, Leon Sullivan. We got to bring all of that together again now and make this work for our people. And I'm just so grateful to you brothers. Sigma is a great, 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 great conglomeration of great men. And they are Jubilee men. And we'll do our part. And we'll recognize and be grateful for others who do their part. I saw Dr. Ratliff on here, and I can never stop praising him for the work he did in helping to galvanize the National Monument to Martin in Washington. Now we got to do the next monument. The next monument's got to be we rebuild cities and rebuild places where people live, where people can be in charge of their own destiny. Resurrect Black banking and institutions, Black colleges and all the rest. I appreciate Harvard. It's good enough to let me come and get my stuff together. Virginia Tech over there in Virginia is doing more right now than most of the Black schools in Virginia, but we're trying to come together. We're losing schools. St. Paul is closed. All of that. We just got to wake up and stop putting on shows and do the work together so that all of our babies can have a new future and old folks can dance and sing as they leave this earth. They say, why walk when you can dance? Why talk when you can sing? Let's sing. Let's sing each other's song. Let's make this happen so that it's good for the old people and the children. And everybody else in between will do just fine. Y'all will pardon me. Brother Lee, you're talking about preaching and stuff. I think you and I, we got the same fire in us, but anyway, we got to get this done. And I'm, again, I just want to thank you. Honey, you want to say anything before we close?
I would like to say, I just want to thank everybody from the bottom of my heart for, it's not a ceremony, it's just a tribute that you all have given my husband today. It's a privilege that the Lord has let him live for 90 years and be active and to share so much with you. And the Lord has been blessed me that I have been able to stand beside him and help him in sharing this. And then we have wonderful children, our son David, our daughter Deborah, and our grandchildren and our great grandchildren. They all stand with us and we're together. And I'm so happy and thankful that God has let us see this day. We appreciate everything that you have done, everything that you have said, and our fight still goes on. We will never give up. We will never stop talking. We will never stop praying and singing. We will never stop demanding what it is that God wants us to do. And we pray that each one in your family and in your associates will be able to continue the work that that all of us want to see happen. Thank you so much for this day.
Would you join me in Thanksgiving to Brother Kern and yes. Brother Rand?
Let's give yes.
Oh, it's just so wonderful. Yes, yes.
Doc, I want to recognize a few more Eta Rho Sigma members. Yes. Too. We've got Dr. Alexander, got Wendell. I think that's Wendell Lofton, I believe. And who am I missing? Brother Eric Cooper. I think I caught everybody. But this is from your chapter. Your chapter came together and it helped to pull this together for you, Doc.
Thank God for Eta Rho. Mm.
Yes.
Thank you. Will the film of this be available, Ramsey? How can folks get a?
Well, yes, it will be, and Brother Hearn is taking care of that for us.
Oh, wonderful! Extraordinary. Thank you.
The video we did too. That the tribute that we did, that will be available as well.
Wonderful.
And Dr. Wood, again, we want to thank you. We love you. You have poured into so many, poured into us. And we just wanted to let you know how much all of us love and appreciate you and thank you for your contributions.
Thank you.
Farewell. I'm going to turn out the lights on me, but this was stupendous. What a blessing. Thank you, Dr. Woods and Mrs. Woods. Thank you to your family.
And we'll see everybody in church.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Janice Thomas. Hey, Janice Thomas. And there's Tanya Hart.
Thanks, everybody.
It's Tanya Hart. See Tanya. Hey, Tanya. Hey. Hey, Janice Thomas. Hey, Michael Jones. Hey, David. Hey, all folks. Hey.
Oh, my goodness.
Shout out to my friends. Here's Janice. I saw Janice. See Janice.
That's Tanya.
Hey, Michael. Hey.
That's Michael. Hey, Michael. Hey, Michael Jones.
All our friends, yeah. Hey guys, hey. Hey David.
Donnie Sanders.
Stephanie. Hey Stephanie.
Sharon.
Hi. Kayla. Hey, I'm making. Hey.
Johnny Sanders.
Hey Johnny.
Yeah. Oh, we see everybody.
Yes, indeed. Good to see you guys.
James.
Where did Carl Moses go?
I don't know where he is.
Yeah, I see him.
Carl Moses. Hey, yeah. Carl.
Yeah.
Wendell.
Yeah.
Ramsey.
Right here.
Ramsey.
Hey. You doing so wrong?
Yeah.
Little Cheetah.
Cecil. Yes.
Oh, my Lord.
Okay. Happy birthday.
Yeah.
Come on, Janice.
Look at Janice, Grandma.
Yeah.
Where's the cake?
Oh, it's over here.
Oh. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's right. Get the cake. Get the
Happy
cake.
Birthday.
Hey. Okay.
Thank you, darling.
I'm lost baby right now.
Put it in front of me.
Okay, I'll put it in front of your dad.
Yeah, yeah. Here comes the cake. Hope y'all enjoy.
Where is that?
I'm getting it. I'm bringing it out right
Deborah's
now.
Getting the cake now.
Get the candle.
Let's see it.
Candles in that plastic. Here we go. Wow. Here's the cake, Daddy.
Okay.
Here you go.
Can you?
And 90 candles on there?
Get a cake.
Oh, yes.
Gonna put a candle on it and light it.
Send me a piece.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, Carl.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Doc, you let that alpha get away.
Say that again.
You let that alpha get away.
Alpha generator.
Pastor Ratliff.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. He was with us. Pastor Ratliff was with us.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He big time alpha.
the party not on until Pastor Ramsey. Oh, yeah, alpha. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's a nice group.
Daddy,
hold up. I'm going to
put the candles on your cake.
So, Doc, was this a surprise or did you know about this?
I don't put it that way. So it was a real surprise, Ramsey.
I had no idea. They were bossing me around all day telling me what to do.
Like that. It'll be like that.
Blue.
Okay, good. All right.
Okay.
Now you're going to light up, Mother?
All right.
I want a piece. Wish you could have a piece.
I'll get a picture of that.
Just send it to Boston. They know who to send it to. No, that's right, Janice.
Now, Sister Deborah and Miss Lillian, y'all come on in with Dr. Wood, and Dr. Wood, give us a big smile.
Okay. Mom, he wants
we're taking a picture.
Look at that.
Do we stand or what?
You can sit down.
You stand, you won't be able to see.
How's that?
That's good. All right.
Now, you got to make a wish. Everybody make a wish. You make your wish. I'll make a wish.
Come stand over here. Stand with Dad.
Many more, Doc. Many more.
All right. Like this. Yeah.
Can't see you. Come down. There you go.
How's that?
Yeah.
Great.
Okay. Right. Here we go. Everybody made a wish. Oh Lord, I'm glad it was only two candles.
Yes.
Now, Doc, I got Grubhub now.
What's that?
I got Grubhub. You can see
Grubhub. Well, we had better than Grubhub, Brother Rams and Sister Shantae, we thank you for better than Grubhub, man.
Yes, yes.
Oh, my Lord. Oh, my Lord.
Yes, yes. Oh, my. What a day. I'm so glad that you guys enjoyed it, Dr. Wood.
We did. Delicious. You know, we're going to be eating on it for 3 days.
I mean, that's really good.
Cook for 3 days. That's all right. No.
No.
Do
you want to move the cake out
the way,
or you want it there?
You just move it to the side.
Bye, great grandpa. Love you.
There are great grands right there, Michaela and Isaiah. Oh my Lord. And Grandpa David hasn't been the same since the grandbabies came. You talk about a grandpa that's walking on air. That's our David.
Yes, they are a joy.
Joy. Joy.
Blessing from the Lord.
Hallelujah. Yeah, that's right. The truth.
Amen.
Amen. There's but a window. Who's that?
David,
window?
I've got your book on my shelf too.
All right.
Oh, man. You deserve to be up there with my dad.
Oh, yeah.
I appreciate that.
That's the collection.
That's right.
That's the top shelf too.
I appreciate that.
That's right. Wendell. Who's Wendell?
Dr. Wood, brother. That's Brother Wendell Lofton from Eta Rho Sigma chapter.
Wonderful. From Austin?
Eta Rho Sigma chapter.
Yes. That's the greatest chapter in the whole setup.
Tell them again, Dr. Wood.
Don't tell anybody. Just let them figure it out. It's a great, wonderful group of brothers, man. Really. Y'all heard Brother Jonathan and Ramsey talk about the Detroit meeting. That was a great meeting, but the brothers didn't know what I was going to do. I was all wild and crazy.
the reason why I told you don't close out with Blue Fi was because you asked me, how do you say it? Is it Blue Fi? And I'm like, no, that's okay. No, don't do that.
Right, that's right.
You, it came out all right, didn't it, Ramsey?
It came out.
It came out. Yes, yeah. Right. That's right.
But what you felt, it spread across the room, and so
yes,
it came out.
Wonderful day, and to realize that that was that allowed them to do for John Lewis what they had put off until that day. I feel good about that. Mm. Ada Rowe made that happen.
That was you. That was you. We were standing with you.
You surely were. Y'all weren't sure what I was going to say, and I didn't know either. I was thinking about Black folks join all of these organizations, pay all this money, and then come in there and fight each other. We know all of the fraternities and sororities do that. All of them do it. Every last one of them. And they pay all that big money to belong and then get in there and scrap and fight each other. If we just have to get real with each other, we do that. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All chapter meetings should be in church. That way they won't fight.
Well, you know, church folks fight too, you know. In fact, church folks fight dirty. Yeah. That's the truth. This is wonderful.
Dr. Wood, I'm going to sign off and happy birthday again. Wish you the very best.
Brother James, I appreciate that so much. All the best. God bless. One of these days we'll be able to be in the same room again.
Yep.
Safely.
All right. Happy birthday and good night.
Good night.
Bye.
Happy birthday.
All right. Happy birthday. What a wonderful tribute.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good night.
Wonderful tribute. Very nice. Okay.
I'm
love you
sign
all.
Off too, Doc.
Okay. Love you
too. Okay. Love you guys.
Love you. Thank you. Love you. Thanks love you. Wow. This is so special.
Uncle Virgil, Aunt Lillian, this is Cecil. I'm going to sign off again as well. Happy birthday. Talk to you soon.
Talk soon.
Okay.
Love to the family.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
So
thank
special. You, so mm-hmm. special. Uh-huh.
Okay, Dad, I'm signing off. We'll be in touch. I love you very much.
Love you, David. Okay, thank you so much. Here.
We'll talk. Okay. Yeah. All right. God bless you. Thank you, Ramsey, and thank you, Carl. God bless you, brothers.
Bless you.
Great.
Doc, looks like you have a lot of cake there. You need to.
No, wish I could get some help from you guys. I'll eat your pot for you.
Oh, yes. I decided to buy a slice for myself when I was at the store today too, just for you.
All right. So
don't tell my wife though.
You already told it.
Hey, Shante, he's just joking.
No, I'm not
joking. That's great.
Well, Dr. Wood, I was so glad that I was able to spend a portion of your birthday with you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
This means so much to us, Shantae.
Well, you mean you and Miss Lily, well, your whole family means the world to us.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank
means
you.
Everything to us.
Yes.
It does. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Brother Hearn, you knocked it out the park. Outstanding job.
Thank Extraordinary.
You. Thank you, Brother Cooper. We worked well together, and it was an honor to pay tribute to such a great man.
Amen.
Great. That was great. How y'all pulled that video together is just remarkable. Mm-hmm. Some of those pictures I had one of them I hadn't even seen. That was great. Well,
Brother
good
Moses,
night.
Thank you for your contribution too. Much appreciated.
It was my pleasure, and to be truthful, my obligation. Because when you meet somebody like that, you don't pass up the opportunity.
Yes. That makes it so even more special. That spirit. Yes. Thank you.
I'm going to sign off.
Yeah. All right now, and we'll talk. Thank you so much.
All right. Have a wonderful evening.
Have a good night. Happy birthday.
Thank you. Happy, happy birthday.
And Dr. Wood and families and guests, I'm going to do the same. Good night to you all. Y'all be safe.
Thank you. Right. Okay. Thank you. Good night. Thank you. Yeah, this is great.